Now, the Morning Majority on 630.
WMAL. 807, Morning Majority, Brian Neiman, Mary Catherine Hamm from the Daily Caller in this morning. Taking your phone calls, by the way, as well on the government shutdown, 1-888-630-9625. We'll get to your calls coming up. But Senator Jim Inhofe is here, Republican from Oklahoma, ranking member of the Senate Environment and Public Works Committee. Good morning, Senator Inhofe. How are you? Good to talk
again. I'm good, Brian. How are you?
Well, I do well. So what are you hearing in the Senate about a government shutdown?
Well, why don't we talk tomorrow? I'll tell you. I don't know. This is my feeling. Everyone talks about it's the end of the world and the threat that Obama himself is making. You know, we cannot do this. It'll ruin our credit rating. All these things that are going to happen. I don't agree with that. We have to do something. Brian, I remember when I went down to the floor in 1996 complaining about Clinton's $1.5 trillion budget. And now his budget has more than that just in deficit. We have to do something about this. And, of course, we're talking about two different things. The fiscal year 11 is what we're talking about now.
Right.
That's through the end of the fiscal year. And I think that the House has got something that I can support now, even though I have opposed these one-year continuing resolutions.
Right.
But this one makes major cuts and does take our military and run it through the end of the fiscal year. That's a major thing that we can do. I hope that will pass. Now, that's only another week, and that means they have to get together and come up with some way what we're going to do between now and September 30th.
Right,
and it's a big thing.
Senator, say that CR does come to the Senate. How does Harry Reid say, we're going to vote no on that one?
He just can't continue to do that. That's the easiest answer, Mary Catherine, because we have to do something. This is our fourth continuing resolution. You can't run government by not doing any of the appropriation bills and then running it 1 week at a time. And I think the American people have really caught on to this thing. So the threat of government shutdown, that doesn't really bother me. I'm not concerned about that. I know you have a lot of listeners who are going to wonder what is going to happen to them.
Mm-hmm.
Let me give them the assurance it's not the end of the world. The choice is not do we have a government shutdown or do we have one. The choice is do we have the government shutdown or do we not face this crisis that we're facing right now. We've got to take a step, and that's what I think we're going to do.
Are Republicans in the Senate unified? I mean, are you guys galvanized on this right now?
I think we are. Of course, I thought that pretty much on the vote that took place yesterday, which I think is a very redeeming vote that I was glad we finally got on the EPA issue. But in this case, I think we're galvanized. I think we're going to be voting as a unit on this, and there are going to have to be some Democrats that would come along with us, or it's going to be pretty obvious that if there's anyone to be blamed for shutting down government, it would be the Democrats.
All right, one more question on the budget. Let's go to the 2012 budget and Paul Ryan's proposal. What are your thoughts on his budget, and it's not going to pass, obviously, next year. But, I mean, how much can you get, how much can Republicans get out of his budget as we move forward with the new budget in 2012?
Well, I think Paul Ryan's right on target. And I think that, again, what we're going through with this shutting down government, and people will think, project that forward a year from now. Do we really want to do that, or do we want to start running government the way it should be run? I think his budget is good. I think it's he's talking about the huge reductions that the American people, I think, are clamoring for right now. So I just think I think it should be good. He's done his work, and it's not completely done, as you well know. But nonetheless, he's got his reducing it by $4.7 trillion over what Obama wants to reduce it. We've got actual figures now that we can use. And now we're talking about something that is significant. When you stop and think that we, in just the years that Obama has controlled Congress, that we have increased spending more in that period of time than the entire history of this country combined, we can't continue to do this. So I think Ryan's budget's right on target. We're going to have to do something for the 2012 year. That's what we're talking about now. I'm going to support it.
Well, let's talk about this EPA vote a little bit. A vote in the Senate to sort of claw back EPA's regulatory overreach, trying to regulate carbon emissions when they couldn't get legislation on it. It went down. It needed 60 votes, went down 50-50. Tell me a little bit about what that means.
Well, it means, Mary Catherine, and you know this because we've talked before, that for the last 9 years, I was the bad guy that said that we're not going to pass legislation to cap and trade. That would constitute somewhere between $300 and $400 billion tax increase on the American people. And for those listening, and there are a lot of them in this audience who think I'm the worst guy in the world, stop and realize that even Lisa Jackson, I love her dearly, and she's the administrator appointed by Obama of the EPA, even she admitted that if we were to pass something legislatively or doing it through through the EPA, it only affects the United States of America. It would not have the effect of reducing greenhouse gas emissions or anthropogenic gas worldwide. So, you know, even if you are willing to take these big hits, it is not going to accomplish what you want to accomplish. Now, what we voted on yesterday is very significant, because when the administration said, all right, you're not going to pass cap-and-trade legislation, so we're going to do it administratively through the EPA, then they had an endangerment finding, which is based on faulty science, I might add. And so my amendment was the same thing as the Upton, the Upton-Inhofe bills that were would take away the jurisdiction and not allow the EPA to regulate greenhouse gases or CO2. Now, that vote finally came up. It had been postponed seven times in the last 3 weeks. It came up yesterday at 4 o'clock. It was a 50-50 vote. The Republicans were all but Susan Collins voted in favor of it. And we picked up Manchin, Landrieu, Nelson, and Pryor from the Democrat side. And so now everybody knows who is in favor of allowing the EPA to overregulate our society and to constitute the greatest tax increase in history. Now we know who they are. So I think that's very significant. And the fact that 50% of the United States Senate is in support of taking away the authority from the EPA to regulate greenhouse gases, that's significant.
All right. Before we let you go, also significant that the administration has done a 180 on Guantanamo Bay. It's going to stay open, and Khalid Sheikh Mohammed will be tried there in a military tribunal.
Brian, you and I talked about this a long time.
That's
my kind of my personal mission.
Yeah.
Every time the president would say, even way back during his campaign, he was going to close Guantanamo Bay, that would be the worst thing we could do, because that would necessarily mean that those individuals, those terrorists, would have to come into the United States, and either for incarceration or for trial. They would be afforded the constitutional rights and all that. So we have a great installation there, and there aren't many good deals in government.
Mm-hmm.
We've had this thing since 1904, and it only costs us $4,000 a year. Why give it up?
Sounds good, Senator Inhofe. Always great to have you on the show. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
Jim Inhofe, Republican from Oklahoma, here on the Morning Majority. We'll take your phone calls on the budget. People lining up already, 1-888-630-9625, on this possibility of a government shutdown, which I believe is not going.